Hello friends, welcome to my channel Majil Parag Jambulkar. In last video, we have seen how to use prepare statement. So basically, prepare statement is used when we have to insert multiple records into database. So when normally we use statement interface and we create statement object, at that time, when we have to insert multiple records into the database, unnecessarily we have to compile insert query multiple times. So instead of doing that, we use prepare statement and just we mention the data which you want to insert into the database. Just like prepare statement, there is one more interface that is called as callable statement, and this is the code where you can see how callable statement is used. So just like prepare statement, we can use callable statement. Callable statement is also an interface and it is used to execute procedure. So in this video, we'll see what is procedure in MySQL database and how it is created. But before that, keep in mind, callable statement is an interface. So here you can see. If you search on Google, callable statement Oracle Docs, we'll get the first link. And Oracle Docs, that is the official website for Java language. So if you open that, so you'll come to know callable statement is an interface. And here you can see interface callable statement extends prepared statement. In the sense, prepared statement interface is extended in callable statement. So statement is an interface which is extended in prepare statement, as we have seen in last video, and prepare statement, this interface is extended in callable statement. As callable statement is an interface, we need its implementation, and its implementation is provided by this. So here, this is the connection object, and here we are calling prepare call method, and inside that we are calling procedure. So here sample is a procedure, and I will provide link of this post in description box. From there you can take this code. Now we will see how to create procedure in MySQL database. So to create, so directly we'll see from the MySQL prompt. So to enter into the MySQL prompt, we are going here root-p, will provide password for the root. Now look at this, every SQL query by default it gets ended by semicolon, but that is called as a delimiter. Semicolon is a delimiter. Now if we want to change delimiter, so we can change it. For example, so first we'll choose one database and after that we'll perform some operation. So this database is already created and one student table is already created in this database. So by default, that delimiter we use, that is a semicolon. So database get changed, and normally when you fire query like this, likewise we fire SQL query or execute SQL query, and this data we get. So normal delimiter that you use is a semicolon. Now suppose we want to change delimiter, so we can change it. Delimiter, and suppose I want to change it to this double slash, so I can change it. Now see, here delimiter is changed and same query I am running again. So instead of semicolon, as I have changed it to two slash, I can mention this. So we got the same result. Here this SQL query is ended by two slash, two forward slash I have mentioned there. Now we will create some procedure. So what is procedure? Just like in C language, we have function. Function, what is there? It is a group of statement. And what is the use of function? To reuse codes. So suppose we want to execute some statements multiple times in our program. So instead of writing this code multiple times, what we do, we group them, and that group is called the function. And whenever we require that code, we call that function. So in this way, we can reuse that code. In just like function in C, C++ or Java language, we have procedure in SQL. So procedure, again, it is a collection of statement. So here we have SQL query. So procedure is collection of SQL query. Now we'll see how to create procedure. So syntax for creating procedure is this. Create procedure, give name of any procedure. Suppose I want to create this procedure, then give round brackets, then begin. In between begin and end, we have to write some SQL query. Suppose one simple query I am writing like this, select star from. So this is a table name. So only one query I have mentioned, semicolon. So normal, our query is ended by semicolon. So if I press enter here, so this part will get executed. That should not happen. That's why we have changed the delimiter. We have changed our delimiter to 2/. Then end. So in between begin and end, we have to write SQL query. Any number of SQL query we can write, and our delimiter is this. So already this procedure existed, that's why we got error. We'll drop that. So to delete existing SQL procedure, the syntax for that is drop procedure sample, and our delimiter is 2/. So query is okay. That means the procedure sample which was existing before got deleted. Now again we will write the procedure, create procedure sample, opening bracket and closing bracket, begin, and after begin we have to write SQL query. Suppose we are writing this query, select star from student, semicolon, that query we are mentioning there, in, and we have changed the delimiter. So what is our delimiter? 2/. So we have created one procedure with the name sample. So here we have mentioned only one SQL query. We can mention any number of SQL queries there. So now to call this SQL query, we'll mention call sample and this. And after that delimiter. So what delimiter we have? This. We have changed it to 2/. So here you can see we got this result when we have called this sample procedure. So in this procedure, we have mentioned only one SQL query. So we'll delete this procedure, and again we'll create the same procedure, but at that time we'll add multiple SQL query. Let us see. So we'll drop this procedure sample. We have a delimiter this. So we have deleted that procedure. Now we'll create procedure sample. In between begin and end, can write some query. So suppose we are inserting one row into the table, insert into student, there is a table name, values. So we'll add some values there, and after that save. So suppose we want to add this to mention in a single quote. Some college name will mention. Like it. So we'll add this row into the database, and after that, suppose we'll call select. Likewise, any number of SQL queries you can mention in between begin and end. So this is the end, and there's a delimiter. So this one SQL query will get this SQL query will add this row into the database, and this SQL query will fetch data from the database. So our query is okay. That means this sample procedure is created. Now we can call this. So here you can see, here we have added this row, and when we call this procedure, so two things we have done. As we have mentioned, two queries there. One was insert query. So by using the insert query, we have inserted this row into the database, and another was select query. By using the select query, we have fetched this data. So two queries we have executed at a time. Likewise, you can mention three queries, four queries, any number of queries in our procedure. After that, if we want to change delimiter, so we can change delimiter like this. So normally, by default, we have delimiter semicolon, so we can restore it. So now our delimiter got changed to semicolon. Reason behind changing the delimiter was this. Here, in between begin and end, we need to write this multiple queries. So this SQL after the query we have to mention semicolon, but after that if you press enter, so this it will try to execute this part, but we don't want that. We want to complete our procedure, so that's why we have changed the delimiter. So when we have mentioned this delimiter, we have changed it, and when we are mentioning delimiter and after that we press enter, so it will execute this part, and what it is doing, it is creating procedure. So in this way, procedure is created in database. And if you want to delete the procedure, then drop procedure and give the procedure name. So procedure name was sample, and now we have changed the delimiter semicolon. So our procedure got deleted. Likewise, you can delete the procedure. We can call this existing procedure by using callable statement. So already I have told we use callable statement. To create callable statement object, we need to call prepare call method by using connection object, and in bracket as a parameter we need to pass this call sample. Sample is a method or procedure name. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.